All right, what's up guys? My name is Gavin. Today I wanted to record a quick video breaking down how you can become a powerlifting world champion. Cause I'm still a kid, I don't know if I'll ever let go of this. Say goodbye to the old me. We ain't friends anymore, you don't know me. I know I could die any moment if I do just remember. Handouts create lazy people, I'm not impressed with. You want something in life, then why don't you go and get it? Actions speak louder than words do, it's pretty quiet, isn't it? Look. I need to preface this with the reality that I'm really nothing special. I am a 93 kg junior world champion in the IPF. I can't stress this enough. I'm really nobody. I just lift some fucking weights. I've been blessed and lucky enough to inspire people along the way, to lead people along the way, to help people become stronger versions of themselves along the way. However, again, I'm no better than anybody else. And there are certainly better people out there in the industry, in my own sport. And I want you to take everything I say with a grain of salt. That said, this is all based on my experience, all right? This is all based on how I got to where I am today, from literally nothing, from zero to world champion in about 2.5 years, all right? So hopefully you can take something away from this, but remember, always take it with a grain of salt. All right, let's just dive right in. So step one, hopefully the camera can focus. Step one, you need to assess yourself, all right? I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This is gonna sound really corny, really cliche, really weird. Do this alone, all right? It's really embarrassing and awkward when you're honest with yourself. When you take an honest look in the mirror and actually think about where you spend your time, what you spend your time doing, who you spend your time with, right? Look at every little intricacy throughout your life, throughout your week, throughout your day. Figure out, what am I doing right now that's creating the present, that's creating the life that I have right now? It's very important that you do this, because what this does is it creates a baseline for you. All right, so now you know where you're starting at. You know your starting point. No different than if you were gonna test your maxes, right? When you test your maxes on everything, you create a baseline. You're showing yourself, you're actually having a metric, you're giving yourself a metric to use to compare progress to, right? And that's how you'll know that you're progressing. It's also really important because it gives you something to compare to the ideal state, right? Obviously, your life may not be exactly what you want it to be if you're watching this video. And it'll never be what you want it to be. That's the beauty of life. We're always working and searching to become something more, to learn, to grow, to push others to grow. It's just part of the game, man. So it's important that we create this baseline, all right? So when I say assess yourself, really what I mean is actually take a look at, what are you doing right now? How are you spending your time that's leading to the result that you have in your hands right now? Like literally how you live your life right now. Again, this is really fucking important. My suggestion is to do this alone. Play some music, watch a show while you do it. I don't care, doesn't matter. But you need to do this in a way where you can be completely and fully open and honest with yourself. This requires vulnerability, all right? It's not easy to do, man. 99.9% of people do not do this. It's very difficult to do, but it's very important that you do it, because again, not only does this create a baseline, it allows you to actually see what's going on in your life right now, right? And that will give you a lot of the, reasons is a bad word, but it'll give you the reasons why you're at where you're at. All right. That's step one. Very important. Step two, design your future self. All right. What do I mean by that? You don't necessarily have to create this insane, incredible vision. All right. That's not what I'm talking about. You don't need to like picture yourself 10 years from now or 5 years, 5 years from now, exactly what you want, you know, what you're driving and stuff. Like, I'm a very visual person. I can do that, and I have done that, but you don't need to get to that level. What you need to do is figure out who you want to be. What kind of person do you want to be, right? How do you want people to perceive you? When you walk in a room and everybody turns their head and like, oh shit, who the fuck is that? What do you want them to be thinking, right? Do you want them to be thinking like, oh shit, that's an ex-con? Like, do you want that? Or do you want somebody to think of you the way they might think of, I don't know, like Arnold Schwarzenegger or something, right? Like, take some time to design your future self. What kind of characteristics do you have? What kind of person are you? Are you reliable? Are you responsible? Are you strong? Are you a world champion, right? Take some time to think about this. And this is really important, because what this is gonna do for us is, again, we've just established our baseline. So now we're gonna create the ideal state, the ideal self. We assess where we are right now, who we are right now, what fallacies do we have, what shortcomings do we have, what behaviors do we have that are not progressing us, that are actually maybe even holding us back, making us worse, right? We assess that and then we design our ideal self. And my recommendation is to find people that you look up to. Find people that you're inspired by. Find people that you really enjoy watching, listening to, learning from, and then take qualities from them that you really like and morph them into your own. You know, decide like, okay, this is, I want this piece from Arnold. I want this piece from, I don't know, fucking Elon Musk. I want this piece from Jeff Bezos. You know what I mean? Like you start to create this ideal state, this ideal person, and that's the ascension. That's what you're working towards, all right? So once we design our future self, now we get into the real nitty-gritty of how to become a world champion, all right? So you're gonna set the goal, all right? And I put a little, in parentheses, I put a little S here, goals as in plural. Reason why is because there may be multiple, all right? When I first started, and I kind of talk about this in the training mindset ebook I have, or that I wrote, that I released, and you can find on my website, gavinadentraining.com. It's free, you can just download it. Anyway, I wrote about this in there. When I started out, it started with just a simple vision of, you know what? I want to create a legacy. I want to be something more than what I am right now. Right now, I feel like a nobody. I feel like I'm worthless. I feel like I'm useless. And yet, I always have looked up to guys like Arnold and at the time, you know, Christian Guzman and Russell Orhi and all these influencers in my space. And I thought, like, man, like, how cool would it be to do what I love, to lift, to train, not only push myself to new limits and to new heights, but also do that for others, inspire people to do that. The way that the people that I was looking up to was inspiring me, right? So then I thought to myself, like, okay, well, how am I gonna do that? Well, I wanna be a world champion. I want something hardcore, something that's undeniable, something that can't be debated, right? So I chose powerlifting as my vehicle to do that, all right? And so I decided 2.5 years ago I was gonna become a world champion. And here we are, right? So set your goal. Now, again, this could be something as simple as I wanna be a world champion. This could be something as simple as I want to squat 500 pounds. Could be whatever ambition that touches your heart, whatever you're actually driven towards and passionate about. Don't let it be somebody else's. Just because somebody else says that they want to be a world champion, they want to conquer the world, whatever, doesn't mean that that's what you want, and that's okay, all right? Do what you're driven towards, what you're naturally inclined to work towards, all right? So that's very important. We set the goal. The next step is to reverse engineer. And again, hopefully the camera's focusing on this so you guys can see it, but we wanna reverse engineer. Now, what does that mean? We wanna break down, starting from the goal, the process to which we can get to that goal. All right, and this does not have to be complicated, man. People overcomplicate this all of the fucking time. It's not worth it. Think very simply. I wanna be a world champion. What do I have to do, right? Well, in my mind, and again, I write about this in my training ebook, the training mindset ebook, in my mind, I'm thinking like, okay, I want to be a world champion. So one thing absolutely has to happen. I have to compete because I have to earn my spot at Worlds, right? So I'd have to win nationals and then get the nomination and get the invite to go to the world championship. Okay, so I have to compete. That's number one. Number two, I have to win, obviously, right? So those two things are very important because competing just to compete is very different than competing to win. So I'm telling myself I have to be strong. Right? Well, how am I going to do that? All right. So I know I have to sign up for a competition and I know I have to be strong. When it comes to being strong, you have two options, pretty much. Option one, go online, do your research, learn as much as you can, program yourself, trial and error, figure it out. It's been done before. Ed Cohen has done it. He's very successful at it, obviously. And there are plenty of other athletes. I have a lot of friends who self-coach and they've been very successful. I chose to go with option two, which was to hire a coach. I decided to invest in myself, invest in my training, and leave it to somebody who's an expert and knows what they're doing and can take care of me. So I hired a coach, all right? So that was already nixed off. I reverse engineered the goal. We said, I wanna be a world champion. So I said, I gotta be strong enough, right? So I hired a coach. That's number one. The second thing you have to do is compete, as we said. So I signed up for the first meet that I could find that was far enough away to give me some time to prep, which was the New Jersey State Championship. That was my first ever meet. What that did was it solidified a deadline, an event. It helped reinforce commitment, which we're gonna get to. So now we're cruising, right? We already set the goal. We said we wanna be a world champion, all right? Now we reverse engineered the process. We said, okay, well, it's great that we want to be a world champion, but how are we going to get there? We know we got to be strong and we know we have to compete. That's the only way we'll qualify. So we took care of those two variables. I hired a coach, right? So I can train smart and actually build strength and trust that I'm going to build strength. And then we signed up for a meet That was the first step, right?
Okay.
The last step. I told you guys this was going to be short and sweet, so bear with me. I know I'm going fast, but I want to make sure that you're not wasting too much of your time or spending too much of your time watching this video. Commit. That's the fifth step. Commit. This is a very important step. Now, there's a lot that goes into this fifth one right here, okay? Discipline, responsibility, accountability, adaptation, all of that goes into commit. It's very, very vital that you fully commit. You have to burn your ships, so to speak, all right? There's a quote. If you're going to take the island, burn your fucking ships. That's the quote. And I have that on my whiteboard over there. That I call it my training whiteboard. I have like a bunch of different quotes that inspire me. That's one of them. If you're going to do something, go all the way. This is another thing I talk about in my training mindset ebook. Commit, fully commit. Becoming a world champion is not an easy feat. There can only be one. Why should it be you? Because you were willing to sacrifice everything. You were willing to show up even when you didn't want to. You were willing to bleed, sweat, cry, all of it. That's the difference between you and everybody else. That's going to be the difference between you winning and everyone else losing. And that's just the fact. How do I know? Because I lived it. And I continue to live it because I'm not done, right? You have to commit. And part of that means consistency. That means showing up every fucking day. I'm telling you right now, most of the training days are going to suck. There's going to be external factors outside of your control that are going to influence how you feel, how you respond to your training, how you think about everything. Doesn't matter. You commit to the vision. You commit to the goal. You commit to the process. This is also why I recommend hiring a coach, because then you can commit to the programming. You have to trust the process. Don't just hire a coach or set yourself up on this path and then just deviate just because you didn't feel like it or because you wanted to, right? Trust the process. The next thing also is adapt, right? I mentioned this before, but you really have to be willing to adapt. That's the key factor, all right? You have to be willing to adapt and overcome. Anything can come your way and anything and everything will, I'm telling you. You have to just adapt. I truly believe to my core that a human's most prized possession in terms of ability, in terms of a characteristic, a trait, is our ability to adapt. Because with that, we can overcome and conquer anything. We can create and innovate anything. There's a beauty in that. It's not supposed to be easy. Nobody ever said it was going to be easy. It's just possible. That's the key. It's possible. Because we combine multiple things. We combine intellect, passion, drive, and a will, an iron fucking will to make it. A refusal to give in. Faith that it will come true, which I'm going to get to. All right? That's commitment. When you commit yourself fully to the goal, right? Fully to the process, fully to the ideal state, because you refuse to allow yourself to remain or revert back to who you once were. That's commitment. That requires discipline, adaptation, responsibility, accountability. Champions take full responsibility for their outcome, no matter what. It's just part of the game, man. You become an amazing person when you do that, by the way. I mean, it's a long, ongoing process, but I can promise you this, like in my journey so far, ever since I truly made the decision to commit to this ideal state, this ideal self, I haven't gone backwards. I've only gone forwards. I am far from perfect, far from anything worth anything, but I haven't gone backwards, and that's all that matters, right? And neither will you. So guys, that's it. There's one bonus step I'm going to give you, but this is it. That's it, bro. Five fucking steps to become a world champion. It's not that hard. It's not that hard for this. It's not. It's not that hard. This was the best male lifter award. It's not that hard for this, all right? And by that, really what I mean is complex. That's probably the better word. It's not that complex, dude. It's not that difficult. There's no crazy secret, all right? There's no... You know, it's just, that's it, dude. That's it. Assess where you are right now. Design your future self, right? Figure out who you want to be, right? Who you're trying to become. Set an actual solid goal, becoming a world champion, whatever it is. And you can set mini goals below that too. That's fine. Reverse engineer it. You have to have a battle plan, right? You got to figure out how you're going to get there. It doesn't need to be complicated, but it needs to be there. And then commit. Sit. That's all there is to it, man. And the difference between you and everybody else, the difference between the people that win and the people that don't, are the people that are willing to give 110% every fucking day. How much are you willing to sacrifice to get there? That's it. Which is scary, but it's also amazing. It's scary because it's like, fuck, man, like this is gonna hurt. This is gonna suck. I'm gonna have to give a lot of myself for this, right? Sure. But it's also amazing because that means the power is within you. You have the control to make it. It's just a matter of what you're willing to give, how hard you're willing to work. That's the beauty of it, right? Okay. Now, where's my, where's the eraser? I got to give you that bonus step. So 1 second. All right. And we're back. I'm going to give you the sixth bonus step, the most important step. So I hope you've stuck around to watch this. If you have, kudos to you. You're going to be 10 steps ahead of everybody else if you do this. You ready for this? A lot of you have heard and have seen and read the word I'm about to write, but a lot of you may not actually know what it truly means, okay? So brace yourself, it's a big one. This is the most important thing. If there's a secret ingredient, if there's a special sauce, this is it, belief. Now, my perspective on this is a little bit different, a little contrarian to most people. So bear with me. Again, I want to remind you, take everything I say with a grain of salt. Just because it's what I believe doesn't mean it has to be what you believe or what you accept. I think you should have belief in two things, have faith in two things. The first is, of course, yourself. You have to believe in yourself. Without belief in yourself and confidence in your own ability to do it, to become a world champion, to actually, I mean, really believe, like visualize yourself doing it. I visualize myself on the world stage almost every single day since the moment I decided that it was what I was gonna do. For 2.5 years, I visualized it. And I'm not fucking kidding. You have to do that. You have to be so confident, so there, so focused on it, that it's not a matter of if, but when. All right, and again, I write about this in the Training Mindset ebook. This is huge, guys. You have to believe in yourself, all right? The second thing, and again, this is just for me. This is what works for me. Believe in God, all right? Believe in the universe, in a higher power, whatever you choose, something that's bigger and more powerful than you. That's key. There's a quote, don't think it's direct from the Bible, but I've heard it from a number of people. Faith without works is dead, okay? What that means is just because you have faith in something, just because you pray about something, you ask for something, you believe in something, doesn't mean it's gonna come true. There's another part of the equation. There's another 50%. That other 50% is work. Your work ethic. Earning it. You have to build it. You have to create it. That's part of it. It starts in the imagination, but it ends in the physical, in the reality, right? How do you think that happens? There has to be a medium through which it's channeled, right? That's it. Work. You just gotta work. And so that's when I tell you that this is so fucking key for so many reasons. Not only does it give you the ability to go in and give it your all every single session, no matter what, because you have this, you just know it's gonna come true. It's not a matter of if, but when. You just know it's gonna happen. Just a matter of time. You just have to keep working. Not only does it do that for you, but I promise you that in your lowest of lows, when you have faith that God's got you, when you have faith that the universe or whatever you believe in has got you, that they'll take care of it. Just keep fucking going. Man, I tell you that that will push you so much further than you think it will. Because I promise you, the adversity you will face to not only get to a world championship, but to win it is insane. It's unreal. And I'm not gonna break down the many steps and the details and all the intricacies and all the shit that actually really does go into training and becoming a champion and all this other stuff and going to worlds. And that's for another video, man. Everybody's circumstance will be different. Everybody's unique. Everybody's problems are unique. Everybody responds to their problems in a unique way because we all come in with different experiences, all right? So what matters is our ability to adapt. What pushes our ability to adapt is our ability to never give up. You fail when you choose to quit. That's it, when you die or you give up. And death is inevitable, so that's off the table, right? When you're dead, whatever. But giving up, that's a choice. That is always a choice. Never make that decision. Don't give yourself the option. That's the key. And again, that falls in line with commitment, but do you know what allows you to do that? When you have faith. It's very easy to say you're never gonna give up when things are good, when you're feeling strong, when your relationship's intact, when schoolwork is good, when your work life is good, when everything else is just easy. But I promise you, when the storm comes, and it will come, you have to have faith, because without it, you will not make it. I'm telling you, this is how I got here. So maybe I'm wrong, but this is what worked for me. All right. You have to have faith, man. You have to believe in yourself. You have to believe that it'll come true. You have to believe that it's going to happen. You have to believe in a higher power. For me, it's God. I trust in God, man. So I'll give you guys a little bit of an example. All right. His past worlds, there were a lot of external factors that fucked with everything. Aside from the COVID situation, you know, and it was tough to travel. I mean, US was literally banned from traveling into Sweden. We needed exemption letters and everything. I happened to travel alone. My coach wasn't able to be there. Nobody from my family was able to be there. Figuring out the food situation, having to water load, having to water cut, everything all together was just, it was all over the place. And then the competition itself felt like a totally different sport. So when you really add everything up, the fact that things still come to fruition, it's fucking insane. The fact that the stars align, like, you prepared for that. You put in the work. But I don't give a shit what anybody says. God plays a role as well. Do not underestimate and undervalue the power of belief. If nothing else, belief in yourself. You have to believe in yourself, man. You have no choice. I promise you, not many other people will. Not many other people will believe in you. And it doesn't start with them. It doesn't stop with them. You have to realize life doesn't come at you. It comes from you. All right. It's when you think like that, you start to recognize the importance of having an internal locus of control, the importance of having faith that not only will you achieve what you've set out to, but that you have the power to adapt and persevere through any and all adversity, despite what's going on around you, because it's that faith that gives you hope. It's that faith that drives you forward. All right. And I promise you that this is such a big deal. And if you don't find that it's necessary in your life, it's because you're not challenging yourself enough. And I said what I said. I know that might upset some people, but that's just a reality. Like, when you are really being pushed to the brink, you will recognize the necessity for faith. I promise you. Struggle will strip you of what little power you think you have. And that's just, again, maybe I'm wrong, but this is just my take on it. This is my experience with it. And yeah. All right. So now, before this video gets way too long and way too boring, that's everything. This is how you can become a powerlifting world champion. All right. And yes, this can be applied to literally anything in your life. All right. So now, real quick, if you guys are looking to get stronger, to build muscle, to progress in your training, all right, and you lack programming, you lack structure, you can check out my website. I have several different programs to choose from. Everything is programmed week to week. It's based on a subscription model, so you just pay a really cheap price per month. I believe most of those programs are priced at $25 a month, which is super affordable. It comes with an app and everything. That's a good way for you to get started. However, I do recommend that if you are chasing a goal like this, work with a coach one-on-one. It's worth the investment. Find a good coach. Reach out to me if you need any recommendations or anything. There's so many out there. Sometimes it's tough to pick and choose. I know of plenty that are awesome, awesome coaches and specialize in different things. So feel free to reach out and ask. But yeah, if you need programming or something that can add some structure to your training, make sure that you're going to get results, feel free to check out my website. You can subscribe to any one of those programs, and it'll do some good. And then the last thing I want to mention is I am sponsored by Rawgear, which is Bradley Martin's brand. I love the clothing, not just for training, but for lifestyle stuff as well. So if you do want to support, if you do purchase anything, you can use my code. It's just my first name, Gavin, G-A-V-I-N. It gives you a discount, and yeah, it supports me. So if you guys did enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Let me know what more you want to see. Yeah. All right. Cool. Good luck on becoming a world champion. I believe in you.